What's up, collectors, and welcome back to the Toy Move of Insanity. Happy holidays and Merry Christmas to everyone. Christmas is upon us. We got about a week or so away from Christmas. Hope you guys are getting ready and doing your thing. You know, I remember when I was a kid, Christmas did not start, thinking about it really until the day after Thanksgiving. And nowadays it's not like that because you go to Walmart and Target, places like that, and you experiencing Christmas stuff the first week of October, right next to Halloween. So what is up with that? But that's how it is nowadays. These merchants want to make their cash. Now back then, you didn't see Christmas stuff really at all until the day after Thanksgiving. And even back then, like Black Friday, it was not really a thing, but people did go crazy on that weekend. Merchants did make their money, but it wasn't Black Friday. But that's when places like Sears, you know, and here you go, Sears, and Woolworths. Also, we got Zodi's. I don't know if you guys remember a place called Fedco, one of the first membership stores. That's when you start seeing that stuff, the decorations and all the crazy fun stuff. But now today, again, it's everywhere. But for me, when I was a kid, when I really started getting crazy with Christmas was once it got to about December the 1st. And especially, I started getting nuts if I saw this commercial. Fireplaces glowing, icicles growing, hearts overflowing with cheer. It's that wonderful season we all find so pleasing, the Toys R Us time of year. The world's biggest toy stores, Toys R Us. The biggest selection, Toys R Us. It's the Toys R Us time of year. That's right, the classic Christmas Toys R Us commercial to this day still drives me nuts and brings back the good old memories. And you know, back then as a kid, I had to make my Christmas list. How many of you guys made a Christmas list? I had to, you know, because my parents, they would just screw up, man. They would forget about or just didn't want to buy some of the things I really wanted. But you know, I always had to help them by making my list. There's about 100 things on there, tons of stuff. And I always made sure that at the top of the list, I would mark it, like that top 10 or whatever. That's the stuff I really wanted. And maybe I got all of it, maybe I didn't, which I never got all of it because it usually was probably really expensive. But it's so funny how my mom and dad would go out to the store and find me this, the Masters of the Universe Attack Track. But they didn't buy it for me. Instead, they bought me this Avengers Remote Control 5 Function Battle Cruiser that sort of looks like the Mode 2 Attack Track. Ah, yes, Christmas, that one time of the year where most kids dreamt and prayed and you know, please God, please Mom and Dad, buy me all my stuff on my list or just buy me that few or that one thing that you really wanted and hopefully you got it. But I'm gonna reminisce a little bit about a couple Christmases that I had and show you a couple of the big things that I just went crazy for and I got them. Yes, let's check it out. For my first memory I want to show you guys in this video is from 1977 Christmas, about, oh, I don't know, 5, 6, 7 months after we'd moved into our house. So we got some pretty cool toys that we were able to get, my brother and I. On the bottom left-hand corner, we have a Shogun Warrior model. Following next to that is the Mego Star Trek Communicator walkie-talkies. And then we've got some Fisher-Price Adventure People's toys. And then we have, kind of covered up by that black hat, the Super Jock football set. And then behind that is something I can't figure out. Maybe you guys can. It says Giant Pit. Here's a close-up look at that. Giant Pit. What is that? I can't figure out what that is. If you guys know what it is, which I'm sure you do, leave a comment down below and let me know. And of course, going zooming back out again, we have the Monster Squad Frankenstein. Remember the Monster Squad cheesy show? Frankenstein Punching Bag. Yeah, so that was 1976. I want to share with you now two other years with a couple toys that I did get for Christmas back then. Some awesomeness, so here you go. So now imagine it's Christmas of 1982 and you're freaking out to go downstairs, at least I was upstairs in my house, going downstairs into our living room. And what do you think I was waiting for in 1982 Christmas? None other than Castle Grayskull, He-Man, He-Man.
What do we have here?
It's Castle Grayskull.
And it's mine.
Not so fast, Beastman.
He-Man!
You can pit He-Man against Beastman playing for the power of Castle Grayskull. You have to put the castle together.
Beastman's escaping!
The throne, Dad! Dad, you saved the castle!
Castle Grayskull from the Masters of the Universe collection. He-Man and Beastman each sold separately from Mattel.
That was the Motu year. You know, I already had
He-Man and Battle Cap that I received the summer of that year when I was visiting family in Canada. And I'd also received Stratos. At some point, my mom had picked him up for me, but I did not get anything else until Christmas morning when I came down and there was Castle Grayskull. I wish I had a photo of it. I don't. It was not wrapped. My mom did not wrap it, obviously, because it was too big. It's a huge box, decent-sized box. I guess she could have wrapped it. But I got him. I got the castle. I got Skeletor. I got Zodak, Beastman, Merman, Man-at-Arms, and Teela. I got everybody. It's all out back then. I also got the Wind Raider and the Battle Ram. It was all set. The first wave of He-Man. But having this, man, I played with this thing big time. I loved it. I still love it to this day. And this is not my original, unfortunately. Some of you guys have heard my story from the past that I had a lot of toys stolen from me out of a storage unit back in the early 2000s. It might have been 2000, early 2001, around there. Everything was stolen. Just about everything, sorry. Long story, but it was very painful. So yeah, 1982 was a year of Motu. And what was your big thing for 1982? I'd love to hear about it in some comments down below, guys. But we're gonna move on to one more year, another toy of awesomeness that maybe you got for Christmas.
All right, now it's 1983. Another huge year for 80 toys. So definitely was more Masters of the Universe toys for 1983, but it was a new thing, not a new thing, but kind of a new thing that was introduced that all the boys were going crazy for, and that's right, that was G.I. Joe. What did I get? That's right, yes, the G.I. Joe headquarters.
It's under attack! It's under attack!
The G.I. Joe headquarters is under attack!
This is it, the G.I. Joe headquarters, and there's never been a command post like it.
Man, the battle tank!
A real American hero!
I've located Cobra!
We've captured a Cobra officer!
Put him in the stockade!
Way to go, Joe! Fire!
We chased off Cobra!
We saved the G.I. Joe headquarters!
G.I. Joe headquarters! All figures and equipment sold separately from Hasbro!
The G.I. Joe headquarters, and there's no figures in here. I guess I should have put some in there, but I just want to concentrate on the headquarters. One of the greatest toys ever created. Actually, a lot of stuff came out awesome from G.I. Joe back in the 80s. Even to this day, they've done some really cool things. Well, I guess up to the early 2000s, they're still doing the 12-inch figures. But, oh my God, so many cool play sets came out back in the 80s and the 70s. But man, this thing. I'd put this up on top of my couch. It was up on a hill, you know? Love playing with it. And yes, I went nuts on Christmas Day with this. I always loved the interior. Oh man, the jail cell, little command post. It's so awesome. Hasbro knocked it out of the park. Who would not want this? So two good Christmases in a row. Thanks to my parents. And the 80s. Let's think the 80s, guys. And we'll think the 70s. If you're from the 60s as well. A lot of great toys. But 70s and 80s, I think, in my opinion, are the two most incredible decades for toys and being a collector. But such an awesome thing to have. And I, you know, this Christmas 1983, I was expecting it to be huge. Because it was. It was massive, the amount of stuff that I got. I was not sick Christmas morning, but my stomach was in a knot and I did not feel great because I was just nervous, losing my mind. Just want to rip all the packages open and go down and see this. And again, my mom did not wrap this. And I don't have a photo of that morning. I wish I did. I don't. But it's still awesome to reminisce and think about it. So there you have it, guys. The G.I. Joe headquarters. And for now, this is my last Christmas memory to share with you. Maybe we'll do some more here next year. Got to think really hard. What happened in 84 and 85? There you go, guys. The G.I. Joe headquarters.
So there you have it, guys. Some of my Christmas memories from back when I was a little kid, just a little nerd, back in the good old days of 77, 82, and 83. So leave some comments, guys, down below and let me know what you guys have in your head of your Christmas memories of whatever happened, maybe toys, who knows what it is, all right? So as always, guys, don't stop collecting. Merry Christmas. Happy holidays and have a great day.